Morning, friends. I'm Nagar from Maths faculty. You know very well, all of you, right? So yesterday we discussed about polygons. Polygons are related information along with formulas. So here, by using the formulas, how to solve this problem? Observe carefully, all of you, right? So first one is, after this first problem, the sum of all the interior angles of a polygon is 2160 degrees. How many sides does the polygon have? Okay, understand. Sum of all the interior angles of a polygon equal to yes, that is 2n minus 4 into right angle. 2n minus 4 into right angle. By using that formula, we can get the n value, nothing but side squares. So observe carefully here. Solution given. Sum of all the interior angles of a polygon. Interior angles of a polygon equal to how much given? 2160 degrees. That is 2n minus 4 into right angle, nothing but 90 degrees, equal to 2160 students. Okay? Right. So 00 cancel. Here observe 9 2 18, 9 4 36. Is it right? Next one. 2n minus 4 equal to 24. Minus 4 transformed itself becomes plus. So 2n equal to 28. Strike it off with 2. N equal to 1:2 = 8. So here, how many sides are there? That is 14 sides. So therefore, number of sides, or simply sides, n equal to 24. N equal to 14. This is the solution for given problems, friends. First, analyze the problem. What they given? What do we find it? Observe carefully. Next one, use the formula and you can get side value students. Right, go for next another model problem. Right, observe the question here carefully. Find the number of sides of a regular polygon if each of its interior angles is 140 degrees, students. In a regular polygon, observe carefully. So, in a vertex, interior angle plus exterior angle equal to 180 degrees. You know very well, students. Interior angle plus exterior angle equal to 180 degrees. Observe that concept here. Interior angle is given, student. We find exterior angle also, student. After that, how to find number of sides? So, we know very well. To finding a number of sides equal to in a regular polygon, how it is, then 360 by x. Here x is exterior angle. Yes, observe the solution carefully, students. Solution given. Each interior angle in a regular polygon. Each interior angle equal to 140 degrees. Next, each exterior angle equal to 180 minus 140, it becomes 40 degrees. Okay, students, next slide. So observe carefully, all of you, right? Therefore, number of sides equal to 360 degrees by x. Here x represented exterior angle. So which implies 360 by 40. Okay, 00 cancel, 4 ones, 4 nines. It becomes 9. So number of sides equal to 9 students. Yes. Observe students here. Analyze the problem carefully. One angle of a pentagon is 140 degrees. So pentagon means how many angles are there? 5 angles. In that one angle is given, students. If the remaining angles are in the ratio 1:2, 2:3, 4, calculate the side of the greatest angle. First of all, sum of all angles in a pentagon, find out students. Okay, subject carefully. Sum of all angles in a pentagon. Equal to. So formula is 2n minus 4 into 90 degrees student. This is general formula of a polygon student. But we find here pentagon. Pentagon means how many sides are there? Five sides student. So which implies 2 into 5 minus 4 into 90 degrees. Into 90 degrees student. 2 5 is 10. 10 minus 4 it becomes 6. 6 9 is 540. So 6 into 90, 540 degrees students. Now, observe according to the problem what they given, observe carefully. Let the angles are in the ratio. So one angle is 40 degrees. Remaining angles are in the ratio students currently. So remaining angles of pentagon. So we are taking simply remaining angles are in the ratio. So remaining angles are in the ratio. So R in the ratio equal to 1:2:3:4 students. Right. Comes to here, let the angles are. So 1 it takes x degrees, 2x degrees, 3x degrees, and also 4x degrees students. 4x degrees. So then that implies we know that, right. First angle is 140 degrees students. 140 degree. Remaining angles take students. X degrees plus 2x degrees plus 3x degrees plus 4x degrees. 4x degrees equal to. How much total sum of interior angles in a pentagon? That is 540 degrees students. So here 540. Okay, observe carefully here. Plus 140 transfer right side becomes minus. 540 minus 140 becomes 400. Here observe this angle. 4 plus 3 7, 7 plus 3 10. 10 x degrees equal to directly students 400. Okay, cancel with 10. Then x degrees equal to 40 degrees. X degrees equal to 40 degrees. What we find here? First we find the all angles students. Then here angles are. So first angle we know that is 140 degrees. Second one here x degrees. X how much value? 40. Next 2x means 80. 3x means 120. 4x means 160 degrees. So that is 40 degrees, comma 80 degrees, and again 3, 4, 12, 120 degrees, and also 160 degrees students. These are the angles of a pentagon. So regarding this problem students, then we find greatest angle. Which is the greatest angle in that is 160 degrees. So here greatest angle equal to 160 degrees. This is the solution for given problem. Okay students, this is the information about polygon. And again, observe students, a polygon having four sides or four line segment is called a quadrilateral. So let us discuss about today quadrilateral definition and also a parts and next the sum of all angles in a quadrilateral along with some related problems students. Observe carefully here quadrilateral. So generally quad means, observe students here, quad means four laterals. So laterals means sides. So four sides of a polygon simply students. Okay, right. How to define observed students here? It is a simple closed figure bounded by four line segments are called quadrilaterals. Observed students here, I wrote here only definition. A simple closed plane figure also taken no problem. a simple plane figure bounded by four line segments. Four line segments are called a quadrilateral. The students, observe carefully. Yes, I take a diagram here. A, B, C, and also B students. Yes, we will draw a line segment with the dotted lines like this also. So, this is a quadrilateral students. I repeat, a simple closed plane figure bounded by four line segments are called a quadrilateral. After the diagram here, A, B, C, D is a quadrilateral. Okay students? So then we discuss about parts of a quadrilateral. Here, quadrilateral is simply written as QDL students. QDL, right? Here, parts. Parts of a quadrilateral. In examination, full form radio friends. Okay? Not only QDL, right? Parts of a quadrilateral. Observe students, any quadrilateral, like this is symbol. In a quadrilateral, A, B, C, D. How many parts are there? Observe carefully, student. In that, how many sides are there? Four sides. How many angles are there? Four angles. How many vertices are there? Four vertices. And how many diagonals are there? Then it is two diagonals only. So here, sides. Which are sides and which are vertices? Which are diagonals? Okay, students, observe carefully. Here, sides. Already we discussed in a polygon. Line segments framing or forming a polygon. Here, line segments considered as sides. How many sides are there, students? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 sides. Which are sides here? Observe carefully. That is AB, BC, CD, and also DA. Okay? Isn't it? Right. AB, BC, CD, and also DA, students. Right. Vertices. A, B, C, D, or vertices. Vertices also 4. That is, so here, A, B, C, and also D. Next one, angles. Which are angles? Here, these are the angles, students. Angles. So, angles also 4. That is, angle A, angle B, angle C, and also angle D. Angle D. Next one, diagonals. What is the definition of a diagonal? So, here observe, a line segment joining the opposite vertices is called its diagonals. Once I repeat, a line segment joining opposite to vertices. Here, A and C are opposite vertices, B and D are opposite vertices. Okay, is called its diagonals. Here, in this quadrilateral ABCD, AC and BD are diagonals. So, how many diagonals are there? Just to prove only, students. That is, AC, BD. This is the information about parts of a quadrilateral. Okay, students? Then we go for what is interior of a quadrilateral, exterior of a quadrilateral, and also a lie of the quadrilateral. So, observe generally, a quadrilateral divides a plane into three parts of distant disjoint sets. Or, observe carefully, dear students, what is that? Next, like this, U, Okay. Once I repeat, a quadrilateral divides a plane into three parts of disjoint sets. Number one, here I take the points. So here PQR is a interior points of a quadrilateral and SP are exterior points in a quadrilateral and U and V are lies on a quadrilateral. Lies are a quadrilateral. Okay, students, this is the information about interior region, exterior region and also lies on the quadrilateral. Now, sum of all angles in a quadrilateral. Sum of all angles in a quadrilateral is how much? 360 degrees. How it is after students? Recently we did the work students. Sum of all interior angles. Sum of all interior angles of a polygon formula. Sum of all interior angles of a polygon formula, that is 2n minus 4 into 90 degrees. 2n minus 4 into 90 degrees. Yes, 2n minus 4 into 90 degrees. What makes how many sides? 4 sides. So then that implies 2 into 4 minus 4 into 90 degrees. So it becomes subject students. 2, 4 is 8, 8 minus 4 it becomes 4. 490 is 360 degrees. So by using this formula, we will get the result of the students. Isn't it done? Right. Okay. Subject here it is. Sum of all interior angles in a quadrilateral equal to 360 degrees. We proved in by theorem also students. Okay. So, okay, observe carefully here.
So in triangle A, B, C,
Okay, in triangle ABC you know that by using angle sum property, sum of all angles in a triangle is 180 degrees. Here angle A means which we have taken here, angle BAC, this part student. Next angle B as we say, next CAB means angle BCA. Here it is like this taken students. Isn't it all right? Observe carefully here. Angle BAC plus angle B plus angle BCA equal to 180 degrees. Which is equation number 1. Which is equation number 1 students. Okay. And comes to in triangle. In triangle ABC. Angle BAC plus this part means right. Angle DAC this part plus angle B plus next C means DCA. Angle DCA equal to 180 degrees friends. Which is equation number 2 by using angle sum property. So adding 1 comma 2 students. Why? Because of if adding both values automatically quadrilateral is formed. So by adding 1 under 2. So first observe students, BAC along with the BAC. Angle BAC plus angle DAC plus next angle B as the same. Next here also angle B as the same. Next one students, angle BCA plus angle DCA equal to. So left side value is computed over right side. 180 plus 180. 180 plus 180 degrees. Okay, right. Comes to. So BAC, DAC. BAC this part, DAC this part. So total taken what we taken here it is angle A. These two replaced we have taken angle A plus angle B next plus angle BCA, DCA. BCA, DCA, both friends. Both replaced what we written here angle C. So here angle C and also angle D equal to 360 degrees friends. This is the very important theorem students. Hence it is proved. Hence it is proved. Okay students, sum of all angles, singular angles in a quadrilateral is 360 degrees. So by using theorem we proved here it is students. This is the statement and we'll draw a diagram ABCD and given objective construction is to prove students. Okay. Next we are going to related problems. It is very important in competitive examination also. Right. What about the first problem observed here for students? In a quadrilateral, three angles are 55 degrees, 65 degrees and 105 degrees. What is the fourth angle students? Fourth angle. So, solution given, observe carefully. In a quadrilateral, fourth angle equal to x degrees. Let me fourth angle equal to x degrees students. Yes, we know that sum of all angles in a quadrilateral is 360 degrees. So then that implies 55 degrees plus 65 degrees plus 105 degrees plus x degrees equal to 360 degrees. So here I've just went 55 plus 65, 120. 120 plus 105, 325 degrees. So here x degrees equal to 360 degrees minus 225 degrees. Sorry for the summation. 55 plus 65, 120. 120 plus 105, 225 degrees. X degrees equal to 365 minus 225. Finally, x degrees equal to how much of the students? 35. So 135 degrees. 135 degrees. Is it clear all of you? Right. Therefore, fourth angle equal to 135 degrees. This is the solution for given problem. Yes, in a quadrilateral, two angles are 80 degrees and 120 degrees. The remaining two angles are equal. What is the measure of each of these angles, students? So here, solution given. So, remaining two angles are equal. We are taken here. quadrilateral equal angles, equal angles equal to x degree students day. Okay, so let's say or let me forget me. Yes, we know that. We know that two angles, that is sum of all angles in a quadrilateral is 180 degree students. So sum of angles property of a quadrilateral. So that is 80 degrees plus 120 degrees plus x degrees plus x degrees equal to 360 degree students. So here 2x degrees equal to 360 minus 200. 360 minus 200, which implies 2x degrees equal to 160 degrees. 2 1's 2 8 is x degrees equal to 80 degrees. X degrees equal to 80 degrees. Therefore, each angle equal angles. Therefore, equal angles. Equal angles equal to 80 degrees, students. This is the result of given problem. The angles of a quadrilateral are x degrees, x minus 10 degrees, x plus 30 degrees, and 2x degrees. Find the angles. Okay, same procedure, students. Solution given. In a quadrilateral. Students, we know that sum of all angles equal to 360 degrees. Okay, first one is x degrees plus x minus 10 degrees plus x plus 30 degrees plus 2x degrees equal to 360 degrees. Okay, students, here x, how many x's are there? 5x degrees. So 5x degrees plus minus 10 plus 30. So it becomes plus 20 degrees equal to 360 degrees, students. Plus 20 transfer itself becomes minus. So 5x degrees equal to 340 degrees. Strike it off into 5. Then x degrees equal to 5, 6 are 30, 5, 8 is 40. So that is 68 degrees. 68 degrees. Therefore, angles are, so here, first one, x degrees equal to 68 degrees, second one, x minus 10, that is 68 minus 10, it becomes 58 degrees, and third one, x plus 30 equal to 68 plus 30, it becomes 98 degrees. Next one, 2x degrees equal to 2 into 68, it becomes 2 8 16, 2 6 are 12, 30, 136 degrees. These are the angles of a quadrilateral, students. This model also different way. So observe carefully and practice carefully. And last model is the students. In a quadrilateral, the angles are in the ratio 3 is to 4 is to 5 is to 6. Find the angles, students. So, ratio is given. In a quadrilateral, ratio of angles equal to 3 is to 4 is to 5 is to 6, students. 3, 4, 5, 6. Let me angles are 3x degrees, 4x degrees, 5x degrees, and 6x degrees, students. 6x degrees. Okay. Next one. We know that sum of all angles in a quadrilateral is 360 degrees. That is 3x degrees plus 4x degrees plus 5x degrees plus 6x degrees equal to 360 degrees, students. 360 degrees. Okay. Observe carefully. 3 plus 7, 12, and also 18. 18x degrees equal to 360 degrees. 18 ones, 18 twos. So x degree equal to 20 degrees. 20 degrees. Okay, students. Then find the angles. Therefore, angles are angles. 3x are. So 3x degree spreads. So 3x degrees, that is 3 into 20, 60 degrees. 60 degrees. Next one, 4x degrees. 4 into 20, 80 degrees. And again, 5x degrees equal to 5 into 20, 100 degrees. And finally, 6x degrees equal to 6 into 20, 120 degrees. These are the angles of a quadrilateral, students. So all models are completed in a quadrilateral. All of you practice carefully, learn carefully. Okay, tomorrow we discuss about types of a quadrilateral and related problems, students.